I want to bring it back to our breaking news now. We're learning prosecutors have filed a new indictment against Paul Manafort. Joining us, CNN legal analyst Paul Callen and former federal prosecutor Jennifer Rogers. So as we look at all of this here, Paul, so these two new, so this is obstruction of justice, conspiracy to obstruct justice. This all relates to witness tampering.
Yes, it does. Earlier in the week, we heard that the Justice Department was going, the special counsel was going to seek to revoke Manafort's bail or his home confinement situation because he was tampering with witnesses in the case. And we were anticipating a spirited argument about that in court today. Instead, what the special prosecutor has done is he's gone to his grand jury and had an indictment handed down that relates to the witness tampering. So the obstruction of justice count is you're obstructing justice by attempting to tamper with a witness, mm-hmm. and you've engaged in a conspiracy to do that. It also does something else. It adds Kalimnik, who's this much-mentioned alleged Russian intelligence operative, mm-hmm. who was allegedly part of Paul Manafort's lobbying efforts in Ukraine, as now a named defendant. He was thought to be person A, who was listed in prior
indictments. Does that change anything?
Well,
that he's actually named now?
Oh, it does change it because he faces serious jail penalties now if he's in the United States. I believe he's still abroad, mm-hmm. so it'll restrict his ability to travel because he could be extradited to the United States on the indictment.
Whenever there is any sort of movement, obviously, with Robert Mueller and his team, the question is inevitably, what is there to be read into this? Is there anything to read into these two indictments beyond just the, you know, sort of the black and white nature of it?
Well, I think that Paul is right. This is really bringing additional pressure on Manafort to cooperate with authorities. I mean, previously, he may have gotten his bail revoked. Sometimes if there's a hint of witness tampering, the prosecutors will seek to adjust the bail. But this means that they really think they have the goods on this count. They actually brought the charge. It's going to be tried if he doesn't plead guilty. And that just ups the ante even more and just puts that additional pressure on Manafort to cooperate here.
And of course, you know, a lot of people look at this differently when they look at how that raises the pressure and what it could mean for Paul Manafort. But there's always been this question of, you know, what could we actually learn from him? But when we were talking about witness tampering earlier in the week, it seemed that that kind of changed the conversation for a lot of people. I don't know if that's still the case today.
Well, I this really does up the ante because prosecutors are not just saying, you know, we want to revoke your bail because you've done something improper. They're saying we're indicting you for a crime that you can go to prison for an extra 10 years, maybe 20 years for. The way the sentencing works on an obstruction count, what it involves other charges is that whatever your charge you're trying to obstruct, it's the same sentence mm-hmm. for this charge. So it really does up the ante substantially for Kalimnik and for Manafort.
What was also, quickly, it was also remarkable, too, as we were talking about this earlier in the week, is that all of this was, you know, allegedly happening with Paul Manafort while the man has two ankle bracelets and is under house arrest with everything else hanging over him. And that sort of paints a picture of, I'm still going to do this? That's
yeah,
a lot.
I think that's right. And I mean, I think that's an important point, too. A lot of people are saying, oh, this is ridiculous. These charges are for things that were way before the campaign. You know, no big deal here. But when people start trying to, you know, go to witnesses and say, hey, let's get on the same page. I want to help shape the story so that it's good for me. I think people don't like that. I think it gives the whole case a little bit of a different tone.
Appreciate it. Thank you both for popping in on this one. Boy, never a dull moment. thank you both.